بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise and thanks belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May the peace and blessing of Allah be upon His servant and final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As to what follows, my dear respected brothers in Islam. Now, my brothers in Islam, the third point I mentioned with you is the fasting itself. This sacred and blessed worship, this obligatory act that we are doing during the day, and that is the fasting itself. And you need to understand, my brothers in Islam, that fasting, and we need to fast properly. It's not about fasting. It is about fasting properly. Most would think that fasting, you have to stay away from food and stay away from water and stay away from sexual relations. Mawsah, this is the pillars of an accepted fast. But now, there's something even greater than that. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in an authentic hadith, as narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he says, لَيْسَ الصِّيَامُ مِنَ الْأَكْلِ وَالشُّرْبِ. He says that fasting isn't fasting from food and water. He said fasting is not, it's not about fasting from food and water. Anyone can do that. People do it for a diet, people do it for whatever other reasons. It's not that, fasting is not that. He said in the hadith, إِنَّمَا الصِّيَامُ مِنَ اللَّغْوِ وَالرَّفَثِ فَإِذَا سَابَكَ أَحَدٌ أَوْ جَهِلَ عَلَيْكَ فَلْتَقُلْ إِنِّي صَائِمٍ إِنِّي صَائِمٍ. Ah, this is the real fasting here. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, certainly, indeed, surely, no doubt about it, fasting is actually fasting from filth, from filthy words you're going to say, مِنَ اللَّغُ, from senseless, useless speech that you're going to speak. That is what fasting is from. وَالرَّفَثْ as well. And he said, فَإِنْ سَابَكَ أَحَدٌ أَوْ جَهِلَ عَلَيْكَ. And so therefore, if someone was to be obnoxious towards you, and someone was to insult you and mock you and swear at you and whatever it is, فَلْتَقُلْ, you have to say and continuously say, إِنِّي صَائِمْ إِنِّي صَائِمْ. I am fasting, I am fasting. What does this I am fasting mean? This I am fasting here, when you say it, it means I am fasting from bad words. Not from food, otherwise this is already something you're doing. I'm fasting when you say to someone that has become angry towards you and insulting and swearing at you, the sunnah is to say to him, I'm fasting. What do you mean by that? Meaning I'm fasting from responding badly to you, and I'm fasting from mocking you, and I'm fasting from swearing at you, just like you have done to me. And surely in this, there is a, as they say, tarbiyah lin-nufus, there is an upbringing for this nafs. And there is one trains himself in when he's able to say these words. Subhanallah, understand, Ramadan, my brothers in Islam, is like a school. In order to graduate from a school, in order to graduate from a university, you need to pass all the subjects. You cannot just pass one subject and fail the rest and deserve a certificate at the end. You won't get anything. وَهُوَ سِمَلِي رَمَضَانِ وَلِلَّهِ مَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. Ramadan, there are certain subjects that you have to fast as well. So you fast from the food and from the drink and from sexual relations. Then you have to fast from the subject of speech and swearing at people and so on. And your eyes has to fast, that's another subject. Right, your ears has to fast from listening to the haram, that's another subject. Your hand needs to fast from flicking to the haram and touching the haram and whatever it is. For all these subjects, you need to pass them in order to graduate from the school of Ramadan, from this college and this university of Ramadan, in order to attain that wanted taqwa that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises at the end of this month. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, as it was reported in Musnad al-Imam Ahmad, that Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, along with his companions, when they used to fast, whether in Ramadan or other than Ramadan, see what they used to do? The hadith says, إِذَا صَامُوا يَجْلِسُونَ فِي الْمَسْجِدِ. When they used to fast, they used to sit in the masjid. And then when they were asked, why are you sitting in the masjid? People, Abu Hurairah or the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, why are you people sitting in the masjid for when you fast, and when you're not fasting, you're outside? They used to say, نُطَهِّرُ صِيَامَنَا. We're purifying our fast. We're so protective over our fasting. We want to keep it so pure and so cleansed and untouched that we'd rather sit down, because outside we might hear something haram. We might accidentally look at something haram. We might accidentally speak something haram. But if we sit in the masjid, at least we can guarantee for ourselves that our fasting would be pure. فَرَضِيَ anhum, they understood that the fasting wasn't just about staying away from food and water. It was actually cleanse the entire fast. Purify the entire fast and let the entire body fast with you. Well, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu used to do this. Yani imagine Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu came and gave us a visit during these days and saw what happens with the people during their days and during their nights. Yani very upsetting situation, wallah. For if the person is able to yani to sit down in the masjid during the time he is fasting, this is better for him and a much more guarantee for him that he'll protect and preserve his fasting. If not, then yani keep yourself away from the fitan. And it is made very easy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has locked up and chained the shayateen. And above this, Allah azza wa jalla has promised in the Quran, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. Allah has promised ease for you during this month. And He promised it in the Quran. And He did not promise it for any other month. He said, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ. Allah intends especially for you people al-yusr, ease. وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ. And He does not intend for you absolutely any difficulty or any hardship. For you'll find this blessed month very easy. But يعني, subhanAllah, you need to understand that the fasting is not just about refraining from food and drink. Rather, it is actually the entire body fasting. And this is exactly what Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu and the companions, when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself يعني, taught us to do. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless this gathering. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us for our sins. And we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala يعني, to make easy upon us the worship during this blessed month. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us people of the Qur'an, people who benefit from the reminders of the Qur'an. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ الْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَ وَبَارَكَ عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ أَجْمَعِينَ.